cards. Hey guys, what's up? This is PlayMat Format.
Today, we are actually playing Cube. We didn't do the whole Cube because we thought that would be boring.
Oh, God.
It took forever. And yeah. Anyways, my commander out of the mystery booster box was Queen Marchesa.
Mine was Animar, Soul of Elements. Before we go any further, so that we don't forget about any of the other stuff, let's talk about Patreon real quick.
Yes.
In order for us to develop and become bigger and get stuff that can help us, you know, make better videos, we need money. And a lot of that money could come from you guys. We have rewards for people who
want to become a Patreon.
Yeah. You'll get benefits and everything. I'm going to work on setting up a Discord and everything. And
you could talk to us, see what we got, see if it's worth actually going on to Patreon and paying $25 a month. At this point right now, we haven't been saving up packs from each box that we opened, which we should have. So right now, we only have 2 packs mystery boosters. This awesome playmat, guys. Look at it. It's freaking Emrakul staring at you. Anyways.
Yeah, it's cool.
And then we got a cryptic command, Perforos, Steel Blooded or something like that, and a Mox,
not Opal.
No, it wasn't a Mox Opal. That one
sold.
Yeah. But it's a $4 card, so if you want just the cards, which I'll bring everything over the next time I come over. If you want just the cards, let us know.
Yeah.
I mean, seriously, if you just want to buy the cards, let us know. We'll sell you the cards also.
Yeah.
So,
Every little bit helps in every way.
Yep.
Anyways, with that being said, remember to share on social media, like and comment and whatnot.
Hit that little ding bell.
Yeah, hit that bell. Hit that bell. We keep forgetting to say that, so you can know when we put up a video. All right, we'll get right into it. So,
you said I go first.
Yep.
So, we already did the rolls and everything. I go first. I'm going to play a Plains, tap that Plains, and play a Mother of Ruin.
Oh, wow.
Yes. I could tap her, target creature you control gains protection from the color of your choice until end of turn.
Alright. My turn?
Yes.
I will go ahead and drop her turn. I will play an Ancient Ziggurat and cast her.
A good land. I will draw. I'll untap. I will play Swamp. And I'll hit you for 1. His life is at 0, guys. I already won. Just kidding. Just kidding.
Oh, alright, my turn.
Also, my buddy here, JoJo, the owner of the show that we're showing, just got an awesome haircut. Check that out.
Well,
oh, you can't. Check that out. Yeah.
Got the side shaved. Kind of.
Alright. You ladies, you know what to do.
Alright, hey.
Go to Patreon. Hook us up, because he's sexy. Anyway.
I'm taken. Thank you. Happily. Very happily.
Lucille wouldn't mind if they were sexy. Don't worry, girls.
Is it my turn?
Yeah, I just hit you. Okay. Four.
So I'll draw my card for turn. I will play my land for turn. And, oh, what? Okay, this should help me. Alright, I'll tap two to play Sheltering Ancient. It's a 5/5 trample. It has a cumulative upkeep at the beginning of my upkeep. I get to put an age counter on this permanent, then sacrifice it unless you pay its upkeep for each age counter on it. So for each age counter on it, I'll have to put a 1/1 counter on one of my opponent's creatures. But it's a 5/5 trample at the beginning of the game.
One of your opponent's creatures?
Yeah.
Cumulative upkeep, put a +1/+1 counter on a creature and opponent controls. At the beginning of your upkeep, put an age counter on this permanent, then sacrifice it unless you pay its upkeep cost for each age counter. So you just have to keep putting +1/+1 counters on my one creature to keep this on the battlefield. Each upkeep. That's...
Yeah, it's quite a sacrifice.
My turn?
Yeah, it's your turn. But it's a 5/5 trample.
It's true. It's true.
I also purposely got one extra chili for you.
I will play a plains, and then I will pass.
Alright. I'll untap.
Uh-huh. Cumulative upkeep.
I'll put a 1/1 counter on your creature.
Okay, you only have... Don't forget to put an age counter on it.
He just became one, guys. What? Tell him happy birthday. Eddie, I will play this. I will tap two. Mm-hmm. Play a Mask of Memory. Mm-hmm. I will tap one. I cannot.
Why?
At 1 mana of any color, tree, you may pull spin this only to play creature spells.
Yeah.
Yeah. Fuck. Pass.
I like that accumulative upkeep thing. Pass.
Untap. Put a 1/1 counter on your creature. Draw. My bad.
And now next turn you have to put two counters on the creature.
I'll tap one. Whenever
equipped
creature deals combat damage, I may draw two cards. If I do, discard a card.
You can't tap that one to place this on that.
Oh, my bad. My bad.
You can only tap that one to play creatures.
Yes. I'll tap two to play Tybalt Raider. Yay! Something I can actually play. With that, I am.
Fucking hate, man. He's already kicking my ass.
I will swing at you for 5 trample.
5 trample? I'll take 5.
I get to draw 2 cards. If I do, discard a card. Oh, I need that. I'll go ahead and discard this.
My turn.
Pass turn.
Pass turn. I draw. I didn't get what I needed. I will tap 3 and play a Timely Reinforcements. If you have less life than an opponent, you gain 6. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. if you control fewer creatures than an opponent, I do, put 3/1/1 white creature tokens onto the battlefield. So I get, I'm just gonna go 3 in there, 1.
Yeah. Okay. That makes sense. Anything else?
That's all I can do. I'm gonna pass. Oh, okay. Cumulative upkeep, I get 2 +1/+1 counters. And this rolls up to 3.
Yeah. Yeah. That's my trigger. What do you do?
Oh, this is not good.
All he's doing is pumping up. Well, now he can actually start doing the 1/1s instead of pumping this guy up. Is that what you wanted to do?
Yes, actually, that is exactly what I want to do.
Okay, so one of my 1/1s, which this will go down to that, and this will actually get become a 3/3. Well, 3/3 instead of 1/1.
How many 1/1s do you want?
Here.
I gave you a
1/1.
If you don't want it, give it to Joe.
Yes, mistress. I kind of like that card, so I might keep it around.
I'm getting mana fucked like hell, man.
Yeah. Sucks.
I will swing at you with a 5/5 trample. I get to draw 2 cards.
4/5.
If I do, discard a card. Awesome, awesome. I'll discard this.
Need a bloom in us. Actually, because you could tap that for any color.
1, 2, 3. I'll go ahead and play Animar, protection from white and black, which I have protection from 2/3 of his deck with this card. I will go ahead and pass turn.
Okay. Untap. Draw.
I do want to build this way differently. But we had to go with...
Whenever you cast a creature spell, put a +1/+1 counter on Anima or Soul of Elements. Creature spells you cast cost 1 less to cast for each
Untap. Upkeep. I.
What creature do you want?
Counter on the.
It's 3/1/1 counters now, because your age counters is at 3. You have to give a creature 3 +1/+1 counters.
You're 2/2.
This is just a 1/1.
Okay.
So this will roll down to a 1/1, and that one will become a.
I cannot do anything. Fuck it, I need to start swinging with him, so I'll swing with a 5-5.
I will block it with a 4-4 and a 1-1.
A 4-4 and a 1-1?
Yep. I like the counters, but I can't just sit here and keep taking.
One green, one blue. I will flash this out to block, or to tap down your 4-4.
Okay. 4-4 is tapped.
Five goes this through, or five
goes
hits.
Through.
Four goes through. So because you got hit by combat damage, I may draw two cards. One, two. If I do, discard a card. Go ahead and discard this. I cast a creature spell, so I get to
put it at +1/+1 counter.
And I did I tap one too many for it? I did. That's okay. That's way past. Creature spells cost one less to cast for each 1/1 count. Oh, he didn't even have a 1/1 counter on him in the first place. So that is one. To remind me, please, if I forget that this is my, my 1/1 counter marker, to let me know how much less.
I've been reminding you about that the whole game.
Yeah.
See, guys, I gave you fair warning. I was going to lose this game.
Pass turn. It's a decent, like when I first got this, I was like, wow, I don't know what to do. And I was like, well, I don't get penalized.
Untap,
upkeep.
Put four +1/+1 counters on something. I got a 4-4, a 3-3, and a 3-3.
Middle 3-3.
Okay, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It becomes a 7-7. And that rolls up to 5.
Shitty.
I just need a red mana.
tap 1/2 blue.
It costs one less.
Yep.
If it's a creature.
Yep. 3/3 flyer. I cast a creature spell. He rolls up. I will shoot you with a 5-5.
Well, now that I got a 7-7, I'll just block it with a 7-7.
Okay. Finally. Why the hell I decided to do that. It was good to start. Yeah.
Then it just pumped up all my dudes.
I have nothing to do for end step. So, caster?
Draw.
Okay.
tap one and play Shrouded Lore. Target opponent chooses a card in your graveyard. And then you may pay another black if you do repeat this process, except that opponent can't choose a card already chosen for Shrouded Lore. Then put the last card chosen into your hand. So that's pretty much going to my hand.
I didn't choose any card.
You have to. And this is the only card in my graveyard.
Well, then we're just going to sit here because I'm not going to choose.
No, all right, I'm just going to put that in I'm just kidding. Hand.
Go ahead. Oh.
He does that a lot, guys.
What is wrong? Oh, no, I need to do it this way. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5.
It costs one less.
Yes, it does. I will go ahead and put a 1-1 counter on him.
You have to.
Actually, it costs 2 less.
Mm-hmm.
So. Oh, I only could have untapped one of these. Anyways. I'm gonna tap 1, 2. This enters tapped. I'm gonna choose green.
Can't tap that for that.
Oh, you know I cannot. Thank you for reminding me. My bad.
Could hit me for 4 because all these are white.
Actually, I think I can hit you for more.
Yeah, you got a flyer.
Yeah. So I'm gonna tap 1, equip my flyer with this thing, and then I will swing at you for 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. When I deal combat damage to a player, I may draw 2 cards. If I do, discard a card. So I'll draw 2 cards. Yes.
I'm tap 3. I have less in life than you, so I gain 6 life. I also have less creatures than you, so I gain 3 more 1-1 gold. Wait, so I just do it. Actually, what am I doing?
7-7.
4-4.
I cannot let this. this go on for much longer.
Okay, I'm gonna attack you with 7-7 and 4-4.
7-7 and 4-4?
Yep.
Oh. Block your 7-7 with this 1-2 and deal 1 damage directly to you. Then I'll block your 4-4 with a 3-3.
Yep. And then. Well, shit, I should have just given protection. In red, and then did. Okay. Pass. Yep.
Expedition. Mm-hmm. I'll play my land for turn.
Yep.
Gets a counter. Yes.
Yep. Each time I play.
Get this. I'll crack my survival evolving wilds. Search my library for a basic land. Green one. Two things happen. First, I have to shuffle my library before anything happens. So. Got a tap?
Tap.
Okay, land entered the battlefield.
Mm-hmm.
So, two triggers happen.
Mm-hmm.
This rolls up.
Mm-hmm.
I land into the battlefield under my control, so I gain a life and draw a card. I'll tap 1-2. I'll play a creature spell, roll him up. Oop. I'll play 1. I will swing at you with a 5-5 and a 3-3. 3-3 flyer.
So 8.
Yep. Because I did combat damage to you, I may draw 2 cards. If I do, discard a card.
I will give this guy protection from blue. I'll swing at you with a 7-7 and.
Seven, seven, and a 4-4.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. the 7-7 has protection from blue.
Yeah. So I will tap. Seven.
Okay, you still have a 4-4 flying.
Or no.
7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Counters, you could sacrifice that and get into it.
I gain a life and draw a card.
Yep.
One, two.
Takes away. Yeah.
It's a one red. Cool.
That goes up plus one counter. Yes.
Yes. Why did I have my life roll up?
That's not your life. This is the counters for him. He has 5 counters.
Oh, yeah. Okay. 3.
But I don't care because I've been to prison.
So I'll move to combat.
Okay.
Your 7-7's tapped right now.
Yeah.
Yay. I'll just. Actually, nothing. Pass turn. I will tap this to draw a card and discard a card. Ooh.
Should have kept my first hand, guess.
He should have.
But I only had 2 lands.
I'll tap this, draw a card, and discard a card. Play and blue. For Susei. I get to look at the top X cards in my library. I can tap 5, mm-hmm. 2 blue, 3 colorless, and I can shuffle my library. Mm-hmm. Or I can pay X and look at the top X cards in my library and put them back in any order. Cool. Yeah. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. 1, 2, 3. Wait, hang on.
You have to tap 5.
No. X. Look at the top X cards in your library to put them back in order. First, hang on. That's not what I want to do yet.
I guess it's not as uncomfortable as before.
You know what? I'll just tap 3, and I'll gain control of your 7/7. Untap it.
Until end of turn.
Yes.
Okay.
So I will swing at you with Onimar, your 7/7, and a 3/3 flyer.
I'll just block my 7/7. It is 1/1. And I'll take 6, 7, 8, 9.
Okay, so you took damage from both of these?
No, just those two.
Okay, you blocked my 7/7.
My 7/7.
Or your 7/7, yeah. So that dealt combat damage too, so I'll draw 2 cards.
Discard.
Yes. I will discard this guy. I will go to my end step pass turn.
That doesn't stay on the battle
shield. My bad. Yeah.
I will play my red mana. I will tap 6, play Voice of Prevence. When it enters the battlefield, I get a 1/1 White Knight creature token. I'll tap this and give my 7/7 protection from red.
Okay.
And I will swing at you with a 7/7 and a 4/4.
I will block the 7/7 with a 2/2 haste.
Can't.
Why?
It's red. I gave it protection from red.
No. I can. Oh no, that's right. We did look that up. Okay. Is that one red too?
No. Okay. These are both white. I just gave this protection from red.
Okay,
so,
so I'll block that guy. Then I'll use this to block that guy. Yeah. I do remember looking that up. That is an interesting fact that we found out not that long ago. That, do I have upkeep triggers on tap? Upkeep. I knew I had any. It will tap 1, 2. Holy shit. 1 blue. Yeah. I'll tap 1 blue. Winder and Eli. Forgot his Onimar.
Yeah.
I will remove count is from Kalani. Heart Expedition.
Sacrifice it and search your library for 2 base playing cards and put them onto the battlefield.
Exactly. So.
Are they tapped? Oh, yep, tapped.
Tapped, but that does not matter.
Kind of does.
So, give me a second. Well, that doesn't matter for me. So, let me shuffle my library first and then they will hit the battlefield. Search your library for 2 basic land cards. Oh, okay. So technically I need to let them hit the battlefield first.
Yep.
Boom.
They're tapped.
Boom, boom. 2 triggers happen. 2 times.
Shuffle your library.
No. They enter the battlefield first, and then I shuffle my library. So, I gain a life. I gain 2 life. Draw 2 cards. Then 4-4, 6-6.
Okay. I'm not scared. Now of that. I shuffle you my just library. Played it.
Remember, what? Anger is in my graveyard.
Going as. Anger is in your graveyard, and you control a mountain. Creatures you control have haste. That's fine.
Cutter tap.
Tap.
I will pay 1. To level up my Kurgan. Mm-hmm. 1, 2, 3, and 4. I am Hexproof. I will tap 1, or tap this guy.
You are hexproof, or you're...
I am hexproof.
Okay, you are hexproof.
Yes.
But your creatures and stuff
no.
doesn't.
And I will discard this.
Okay.
I will then... So a 3/3.
I'll block it with a 3/3 flyer.
Okay.
My turn.
Yeah.
Untap.
Nobody's by that toy, and it just went off, like it always does. Have you not gotten enough to play your commander yet?
I can play my commander, but it'd be stupid.
Oh, because then it just lets me draw more cards, right?
Well, it lets me draw 1 card, then you could just hit me in the air and take it, and then you get to draw a bunch of cards. There's no point.
Actually, no, it doesn't.
How does it not?
You cannot target me with that.
It's not a target. It becomes your permanent if you hit me.
Yes, but what I'm saying is, if I'm the monarch, right? At the beginning of your, if an opponent is the monarch, oh, that's literally okay. Yeah. Yep. No, that would still work. Wait, hang on. How does Monarch work exactly?
If you hit me, the Monarch becomes yours. Pretty much that's it.
That's just a mechanic of the game, right? It's
yep.
a part of the game.
Yep. Okay.
Then I'm pretty sure which Venom Orb wouldn't keep that from happening.
Tap 6, and I'll play this guy. When he enters the battlefield, you may put target artifact or creature card from your graveyard on top of your library. So I only have one creature card in my graveyard, so I'll put that on top of my library. I probably shouldn't have done that. Pass.
Untap. Do I have any upkeep triggers anymore? No. I will play my land for turn. Two triggers. I gain a life. Draw a card. And it becomes +2/+2 until end of turn.
So it becomes a 4/4 until end of turn?
Yes, 4/4.
Okay.
Do you have a flyer on the field right now?
No.
Okay. I will tap 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Creatures I control have double strike.
Oh, no. That's an
enchantment.
It's an enchantment. Okay. So I'm basically dead.
I'm gonna swing you with a 2/2, and I'm gonna swing you with a 2/2.
It's a 4/4.
Oh yeah, 4/4. Yeah. So that's
so
it.
So I take it. And it just killed me.
How? You have a whole bunch of stuff to block with still that can kill my stuff in the first hit.
You could attack me with this because everything's white and black.
Well, I did already say last turn, so that's a thing. I think for once I actually built quite a broken deck.
Yeah, I didn't get my lands right away.
That's very true.
That I needed. I should have kept my first hand with 2 mountains. I told you you were probably gonna win this. Step 6. Play that. Game 1-1. And give this guy protection from blue. Seven, a 4/4, 3 1/1s, and a 4/6.
From blue?
Yep.
I'm gonna block with my 2/2. So your 7/7 has protection from blue?
Yep.
Okay, then I'll squad it with this big ass fucker. Just a tiny fucker right now.
Okay.
Then there's a 4/4.
A 4/4, a 4/6, and 3 1/1s.
The 4/6, I'll block with the 6/6. That has protection from white and black. 4. Mm-hmm. I'll tap it down and draw a card. Mm-hmm. And so that leaves 2?
3.
3?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, this thing. Yeah.
They're all wounds. Beastery right here are just wounds.
Okay. So I will take 2.
You'll take 3,
three
unless
three.
You black.
Yeah. Okay. My turn?
Yep.
Oh, fuck. God damn it. Remember when I was doing all that land bullshit?
Mm-hmm.
I finally fucking got my other one. Okay, so... Before I tap 2... It doesn't really matter, but... Play this, whenever land she's got a foot on my control, make the quest counter on that. Did I play land this turn?
Nope.
A 2/2 flyer.
Well, I can block the 2/2 flyer with a 3/3 flyer. And I'll take 6 and die.
Okay.
That was a game, guys.
If I wasn't going to be able to do that, my next plan was just to sit there and wait and play Blasting Station.
Yeah, this is the card I wanted for this deck. You saw all those little ones.
Yeah. It was going to be that, and I had this thing. But that's high mana cost. And God, this was such a wonderful deck.
You were just lucky.
Yeah, I did get very lucky.
He had the mana curve, I did not. And I didn't get any of my kill spells.
I really would like to write down this before we sell it. Guys, this was from that box that you saw us open, that mystery box?
Yeah, right? Mystery booster box.
Oh my god, we got such good
and
stuff.
And I couldn't
it.
Get my last mana, because if I did, if I could have got 7 mana, I could have played that, then I could have brought this to my hand and played it the next turn. And then...
Oh.
Gain a bunch of life and then pay 50 and kill him, but I couldn't do it. I didn't have my mana curve.
Yeah. Well, guys, we're gonna sell all of these really expensive cards.
If Card Kingdom is taking them at this moment, because half the cards I got, they weren't taking. So.
Yeah. We'll have to see, and then whatever they don't take, obviously, I did pretty good in building this deck. I'm really, that anger was nice. But it's a very expensive card. I would like to keep Anger at some point, but Cruz and I already talked. I think the two main ones that we are going to keep is our commanders, no matter what.
Commanders, Witchbane Orb, and Aurelia's whatever that was called. Aurelia's something.
Oh, I really would like to keep this one too, but Witchbane Orb is something that I've been needing to get for the longest time. Alright, guys.
But it was so cheap. Why didn't she just buy it?
I don't know. I don't know. Now I have one. And I didn't have to pay for it. Well, I kind of did. But I got a bunch of other good shit, too. Yeah, guys. Like, share, subscribe. We talked to you guys about Patreon already.
Remember, hit the bell.
Hit the bell. Please hit the bell. Also, stay safe out there. Wash your hands. Use hand sanitizer. And try not to touch doorknobs. That's where 90% of germs are. Alright. Have a good night. This has been PlayMat format.